Over the past month, I've been working on my new project. It's called Sacred Forest, and it's an open-world action-adventure game where you play as a pixel art, bow-wielding heroine set within a diverse forestscape. It focuses on fast-paced, high-action combat. You can quickly take out enemies with your bow, master slow-mo archery, glide with your cape, swing with grapple arrows, and battle blight-infected monsters to restore balance to the forest. It's developed in Godot 4, and you can even wishlist it on Steam right now. I'll leave a link down below. When I started this project, I wanted to make something special, so I came up with a few key ingredients that I would use for the entire development of the game. Here's my list of what the game has to have: a strong visual style, extremely fun gameplay and feel, and a cool overarching story slash setting to tie it all together. It sounds simple enough, but I'm forcing myself to make all my decisions based on those three ingredients. Since I've worked on games in the past, I know how important it is to keep my scope focused on the things that actually matter, and so always asking myself if adding a feature will help with one or more of my three rules, it will help me filter out things that could cause the game to take a lot longer to make and not really add much value. First of all, I wanted some kind of unique visual style. I'm definitely more of a programmer and not really much of an artist, but I have been working on my art skills for the past few years to try to round myself out as a game developer. I've made and released a few games on Steam in the past, but they were all 2D pixel art games, so for this one, I really wanted to make a 3D game. I have a decent amount of experience making 3D models for previous aerospace jobs that I worked at, so I feel pretty comfortable using Blender to make assets as needed for the game, but I really didn't want to just abandon pixel art because it's something I enjoy making and I feel like I've been improving at it, so I want to keep that up. I've seen some 3D pixel art games in the past, and I thought they were pretty cool. It does seem like normally they're either an RPG or an FPS. One of my friends even released a 3D pixel art FPS called Diluvian Ultra, which was pretty neat. I didn't really want to make an FPS or an RPG. I like seeing the full character in 3D, so I think third person is the way to go. Which definitely brings a lot of challenges to making the game, but I think it's worth it. So for my first rule for the game, a strong visual style, I chose to make a third-person pixel art main character, and I drew inspiration from other games and movies that I've really enjoyed. I kind of feel like when games have pixel art enemies in a 3D world, it can really limit what can be done from a gameplay standpoint, since they're essentially just a billboard. So for Sacred Forest, the main character and all NPCs will be done in pixel art, but all enemies will be done in 3D. Because I want to satisfy my rule of a strong visual style without stomping on my second rule, which is to have extremely fun gameplay and feel. At a minimum, in order to have fun gameplay, the player character needs to have really good movement. So I started work by designing all the animations for my character movement, which, because the character is third person, I had to make multiple sets of run and idle animations to account for where the camera would be relative to the player. If the player is running towards the camera, then you see the front of the character, but if it's running to the side or forward, then you see the side and forward animations. This took a lot of frames and was quite a bit of work to put all together, but once I got it in the game, it just felt really cool. But I might be biased. In order to make decent animations, I have to compensate a bit for my art skills, which the best way to do that is by getting a lot of good references. PureRef is a tool that lets you just throw images into a void and you can move them around and zoom in and whatnot to create a collection of references for whatever animation you're working on. I've made a decent amount of run animations in the past, but they only ever had to be in one straight-on 2D perspective. So in order to make an animation that looks somewhat cohesive in different perspectives, I used a 3D pose tool to just pose a 3D character to match my run animation in a straight-on perspective. Then I rotated the camera and took screenshots for each frame to use as my reference images. This helped a lot, and I think it turned out alright. Aside from running around, I added flight mechanics so players can use their cape to glide around. This has been done quite a bit, and definitely wasn't enough to satisfy my rule, so I added grapple arrows, which lets you grapple yourself up to high places, and even swing around like that guy that got bit by a spider. For combat, players run around and shoot arrows in third person, so I had to double the amount of pixel art again based on if the bow is readied or not. While it's pretty awesome running around hitting elite no-scope 360s all day in third person, I felt like it needed just a little something more, so I added the slow motion first person view, which lets you slow time to unleash a huge flurry of arrows. This felt awesome. In combination with all the movement controls, slinging myself around with the grapple arrows, gliding with my cape, and then slowing time to take out a bunch of enemies all at once, it just felt right and tied everything together. Aside from the main character, to help with the game feel, I even designed my own spatial audio system, which dynamically controls different audio filters depending on if sound is coming from behind a wall or how big a room is. I feel like good sound is really important to a game, and I did end up making a tutorial on that as well. For my third and final rule, I decided the game would take place in a forestscape. There'll be different biomes to the game, since just one forest would get monotonous, but I want to have an overarching plot of defeating the blight that has infected the forest and taking over lost souls. Because this is an open world game, it creates a lot of challenges to actually develop the game in a way that will be able to scale up to a fairly large world. Godot is the game engine that I'm using to build this game, and it really isn't made for large open world games. It also really doesn't have any tools built in for things like terrain or water, and you have to be pretty careful early on to plan how the world will be built so it can actually run on normal PCs, instead of just nitro-octane megacore supercomputers. I don't really plan on making Sacred Forest a massive world. I'd much rather have a smaller world and fill it as much as possible with content instead of a huge barren game, since those usually feel empty and repetitive. Luckily, there are some plugins that seem like they're going to help out to build the game, but I know that this will be an ongoing challenge throughout development. If you guys want to learn more about how I'm scaling up my world and building it out, or really just any specific details about how I'm developing the game, just let me know down below and I could make a video that goes more in depth of how all of that works together. There's a lot more work to be done on Sacred Forest, but I really feel like things have come together over this past month, and I'm really excited to continue working to make this game as good as I possibly can. I'll do my best to make devlogs when I have time, but I only want to make them when I feel like I have enough content that's worthy to talk about. So it would mean a lot to me if you consider subscribing. Anyway, check out the Steam page if you want. Or not. Until next time.